I really need to get this little garden table painted. And I need to do it today. Blue paint, green paint, and black paint. And I'm going to mix it to see if I can create kind of the same color as the beautiful big ceramic pot that I have outside. Let's mix up some paint. Are you admiring my beautiful marble? I think you should go outside. Let's see if you want to come with me. The butterfly flew away. I think it was just a little bit confused. Of course, when you mix up different paint colors, you do need to be sure that it is the same kind of paint. You can definitely not mix water-based paint with synthetic paint. So I definitely need more green, and it needs to be a lot darker than what I have right now. So let's add some more green. And some more black. I think I will go see if I can find some very dark green, because it still looks pretty blue to me. Last little bit of black paint, and then I'm going to take it outside to compare it to the ceramic pot to see what it needs. This is not bad, but I do think that it needs to be darker. I could not find any more black paint, but I did manage to squeeze out a little bit more black paint from the little can that I already had. So it is a tiny little bit darker, and it needs at least 2 coats of paint anyway. So if I'm not happy with it, we can always go to the store, buy a little bit more black paint and make the second coat a little bit darker. I do think that this is a nice color. It is the same color as the ceramic pot. So let's paint. Paint often also looks a lot darker when it is dry. So maybe it is not even going to be necessary to add more black. It is always very satisfying to paint spindles. I have no idea why, but it just is. I think it is pretty, and I also think it is going to look very nice against the marble top. The flower that I put the butterfly on is called Scabiosa. It is the most amazing butterfly attracting plant ever. So if you like butterflies and you have a little space for some butterfly friendly plants somewhere in your garden or your balcony or just simply next to your front door, I would definitely recommend buying a Scabiosa plant, because they are amazing and very beautiful, and they flower for such a long time, almost the entire season if you just deadhead now and then. You really do not need a lot of space to make a few bees and a few butterflies very happy. I am actually planning on doing a little project around my house in Amsterdam. No, I do not have a garden, or not a real garden. I do, however, have something called in Dutch a geveltuintje. Gevel means the facade of your house. En tuintje means tiny little garden. And I have a geveltuintje. You did not know that, did you? That's probably because I have the most ugliest geveltuintje in the whole of Amsterdam. Or maybe not, because a lot of geveltuintjes look very horrible. Een geveltuintje is really, really tiny. You just remove a few tiles from the sidewalk. And that's where you create your little garden. And I do think it is very hard to stay interested in a tiny little space like that. Because it is not really a garden that you sit in. And I think geveltuintjes often are very neglected, as mine. And I really should do something with it. If it's not for me, then I should do it for the bees and the butterflies. So that's a project that is coming up, because I'm going home in 2 days. I really want to finish this little project over here. And then I'm going to see if I can spruce up my geveltuintje a little bit, because it needs it badly. I think it could be a very nice challenge to see if I can get my geveltuintje so nice that I'm not going to ignore it anymore in the future. So let me know what you think. Do you want to see my tiny Amsterdam geveltuintje? The first plant is Cortaderia celloana. It is native to South America and it is considered one of the most spectacular ornamental grasses. Extremely beautiful, it features magnificent dense tunics of arching narrow green leaves with margins like razors that are gracefully topped from late summer to midwinter by huge, silky, silvery white cream or dusty pink plumes. It can grow up to more than 2 meters tall, so it will only live in this pot for this season or 2 seasons at most. Hebe topiaria is a tidy and compact evergreen shrub. It has striking foliage of densely arranged small, pointed, deep gray-green leaves. It likes a sunny or light-shaded place, and in summer, beautiful white flowers will appear. It is a very easy plant that needs almost no attention at all. In this beautiful container, I'm planting Lavendula augustifolia that does not fit in my color scheme of green and white at all. Together with the Lavendula, I am planting Cerastium tomatosum, also called snow in summer. It is a low-growing perennial that forms a dense mat of silvery gray foliage dotted with white star-like pristine white flowers. This beautiful little plant is evergreen. It spreads quickly by reseeding itself and it makes a great ground cover for sunny areas in your garden. It flowers in midsummer and you can divide it very easily in spring or fall. Don't be scared to cut it all the way back in spring, because it will grow back very quickly and it will look beautiful for the rest of the season. Muhlenbeckia, definitely one of my favorites, is a fast-growing ground cover. But of course, you can also put it in a pot and it will start to spill over the edges like a beautiful sea of green. Adding a bright note to the garden, Yucca gloriosa variegata, also called Spanish dagger, is a very ornamental broadleaf evergreen shrub. In early summer, it is topped with a dramatic flowering stalk reaching 4 feet tall. with beautiful bell-shaped creamy white flowers. This plant does not like to stay wet for too long, and this can be a problem over here in the Netherlands. So I added a lot of gravel to the bottom of this pot. I added even more gravel into the soil mixture, and it is going to be a little experiment. I'm very curious to see how this plant is going to do in my garden. I do think it is absolutely gorgeous, and I'm very curious to see if it will flower. Just adding some bubble wrap to this bold and beautiful ceramic pot is going to assure that it will not crack when it is going to freeze in winter. In this pot I am planting a beautiful ornamental cherry tree called Prunus Snow Fountains. It is regarded as one of the finest weeping cherries, blooming for about 3 weeks in mid-spring, a profusion of fragrant snow-white single flowers emerge from pink buds and smother the bare branches. As the flowers wane, the ovate dark green leaves emerge and create a fresh summer canopy before warming up to a brilliant shade of golden yellow and orange in fall. I am underplanting this tree with more Cerastium tomentosum and Lobelia erinus. This is a white flowering annual that will flower all season long, and I think it is going to look beautiful when these plants are starting to spill over the edge of this beautiful ceramic pot. Rogier saw this tree in the garden center, he fell in love with it, and I am so happy he did.